How do blind people edit videos? Well, you're gonna find out. Hey everybody, what's going on? So, I'm really happy, and you know what? I'm happy for two reasons. One is because I'm just excited for this collab. This collab is just awesome. And two, I'm happy because this video's out in the first place. Because seriously, long story short, this video literally took a year to make. That's another story for another day, but yeah, I'm just glad that we're finally posting this. We jokingly called this the cursed collab. So anyway, this collab is about how blind people create and edit videos, and this is a collab with the awesome Tamara from the channel Unsightly Opinions. If you've never heard of Tamara before, I highly recommend checking out Unsightly Opinions. She has awesome content there, solid, it's just very informative. If you ever want to learn about any topic regarding blindness, definitely go check out Tamara's channel. I'm going to leave a link in the description of the video. But anyway, I'm going to let Tamara introduce herself. So yeah, Tamara, take it away.
Thanks, Juan. Hi, I'm Tamara from Unsightly Opinions. I have a condition called oculocutaneous albinism, which means that I produce no pigment. What that means for my eyes is that I have always been legally blind and had a severe visual impairment for my entire life. I lost most of my remaining vision in my preteens due to an optic nerve atrophy condition. On my channel, you can expect the unexpected. We cover it all. From current events and controversies, to canes and guide dogs, to living life with blindness, and even a little technology tossed in for spice. I hope you'll come check out my Unsightly Opinions.
So, like I said, this is a two-part collab. Half of this is going to be on Tamara's channel, the other half is on my channel. On Tamara's channel, we're going to be talking about how we film videos as blind people. On this channel, in this video, we're going to be talking about how we use Final Cut Pro to edit our videos as blind people. As an aside, yes, blind people do edit videos, and in the case of myself and Tamara, Final Cut Pro is our platform of choice. So for those of you who don't know, a screen reader like VoiceOver, it's something that audibly reads back basically any item, element, button, etc. that's on your computer, your cell phone, your tablet, your watch. So I just want to mention one quick thing before we get started. There's going to be a lot of carryover, so in case I don't mention something like a certain step, if I don't happen to say something, if you're wondering how I do this or do that, it's because Tamara already said it prior. So let's get this started. So let me start off by telling you how I use magnification features to basically get in close and do my edits that way. A few years ago when I had a little bit more vision and also when I didn't know how to use VoiceOver on the Mac, I relied mostly on what's called zoom magnification. What this does, it basically enlarges the screen, but it also does something else. This feature can be found under System Preferences and Accessibility, so let me go there really quick. And now what I'm going to do is I'm going to magnify the screen by holding down the control key and sliding two fingers up on the trackpad.
Test audio. Overview. Accessibility. Accessibility. Use scroll gesture with modifier keys to zoom. Checked. Control.
So as you're noticing, what this does is that as I'm moving my cursor over any text, it's reading it back out loud. And this comes in really handy, especially if I'm moving around Final Cut, if there's really small font and I'm not able to read it, or if I have to use any sliders, this definitely helps me just get in close to tweak those settings. So to zoom out, same thing, hold down control, slide two fingers down on the trackpad. Let me jump back into Final Cut. And now I'm just gonna make my way around really quick to show you how it works when you're using it in Final Cut Pro.
Audio. Waveform audio. Waveform audio. Test audio.
So I'm in my library right now.
Range selection, 35.38 seconds. Project timeline. Contacts. Project timeline. Title, test audio.
Now I'm in my timeline. Audio. Gonna select the clip really quick. Make my way to the inspector.
Final Cut Pro. Rotation scrubber, 0. Opacity scrubber, 100.0. Blend mode.
And you can get it really close. So definitely this is the way to go if you're low vision and you want to use Final Cut. If you ever wondered how accessible is it, well, with this feature, it makes it pretty accessible. Now, just to let you know, I don't really use zoom magnification anymore. For a few tasks, yes, but for the most part, I use VoiceOver now. It helps so much more. It prevents eye strain and it just prevents me from getting migraines. Now, importing files. It sounds easy, and it is once you get to know how to do it, but how exactly does it work when you're blind? So, Tamara, how do you import footage?
To import footage, I use a lot of shortcuts. I used to do this manually, but I find shortcuts make it move a lot quicker and a lot more efficiently. So the first step to importing footage is I press Command-I to open the import window.
Media sidebar, table, desktop, F-import sidebar, desktop image, selected. You are currently on a take.
Then I'll navigate to the files I want to import.
Vertical splitter, video, dip, previous, plate, next, horizontal, organizer, list, live view, splitter, in organizer, horizontal, back forward, shorts, organizer, film, list, outline, view, table, in, start, 00, colon, name, ad/tv.wav, compliments.mov, compliments.wav, dreaming.mov, dreams.wav.
I've found the two files I want to import.
Dreaming.mov, added to selection, two.
And I'll keep track of the names. So my .mov file is the one I want to play on my main timeline, and the one called dreams is my audio file, and I want that to go below. So I'll select both of those, navigate out of the list, and then I'll go to the end of the window where I can select import items.
Out of organizer, to clip appear, create archive, add, create, genuine, event name, scroll, close window after, stop import, import, default button.
And then I hit enter to import them.
Media, you are currently on layout area. Final Cut Pro has new window.
Now that I know the footage has imported, what I want to do is I want to move to the main timeline where I want to build my story. So I'll press Command 2.
Timeline.
To make sure I'm focused on the timeline, and then I'll press home to move to the beginning of the timeline.
Beginning.
Once I move to the beginning, I'm going to try and find my clips. So I need to navigate to the inspector, which I can do by pressing Command 1.
Events, group, libraries. You are currently on a group. To interact with items in this group, press Control, Option, Dreams, group. Final Cut Pro has new window.
So there is the audio file.
Dreaming group.
I found the main video file, and all I'm going to do to insert that into my timeline is press E.
Append to storyline.
So it's been appended to my storyline. Next, I'm going to press Command 2 to go back to my storyline.
Project timeline, layout area, timeline. Final Cut Pro has new window.
And I am going to press home again to move my playhead back to the beginning.
Beginning.
Now I'm going to press Command 1.
Events group, libraries.
To move back to my events window. And I am going to try and find dreams. And then I'm going to insert that underneath.
7,145.22 seconds. Skimming playhead value indicator. Final Cut dreams group. You are currently on the group.
I now have dreams, and I'm going to press Q to add that to the storyline underneath.
Connect to primary storyline.
So they should now be connected, and I'll press Command 2 to move back to my storyline where I can start my editing. I'll pass it back off to you, Juan.
With importing footage, it's basically the same as Tamara mentioned, so I go through that long process of looking through my files. The thing I want to mention, though, is that I do name my files. When using a screen reader, I don't want to be just going through a bunch of files that basically have the exact same name, just with a different numerical value. So I do this just to make life easier, and I don't have to just go through a bunch of files that I don't need. But this is how I do things with VoiceOver. So I have an audio and a video clip already imported, so I'm going to head to my library by pressing Command 1.
Events, group. Final Cut Pro has new window.
I'm going to interact with that by pressing Control Option Shift Down Arrow.
Test footage, group.
Now I'm going to press Control Option and right a few times.
Test footage, group.
Okay, actually, I'm already there. So to go to the beginning of this clip, I'm going to press FN or globe and left arrow.
Test footage 0000. Zero, zero,
zero. Now I'm going to mute VoiceOver because footage, I'm actually trying to hear something that's audible to queue up.
VoiceOver muted.
Okay, to play this back, I'm going to press the L key. And to make it play back a little bit faster, I'm going to tap on the L key a couple of more times. I'm looking for a hand clap here. Okay, there it is. I stopped it by pressing the K key. Now I'm going to play it backwards by pressing J. Okay, stopped it again with J. Now I'm going to go frame by frame with the right arrow until I find that hand clap. Okay, so I'm going back and forth with the left and right arrows. Now I'm going to press my letter I, mark my endpoint. Now I'm going to tap L a couple of times just to get a decent sized clip to import into my timeline. Okay, so I'm going to stop there and press the letter O, mark my out point, unmute VoiceOver.
VoiceOver unmuted.
What I'm going to do now is I'm going to press the letter C.
Select clip.
And then Control Option Return.
Test footage group.
And now I'm going to press the letter E to append to storyline. Normally this puts things at the very end, but because there's nothing here, it's just going to put it at the beginning. So I'm going to press the letter E.
Append to storyline.
So if I want to head down there to my timeline, I'm going to press Command 2 just to make sure.
Project timeline, layout area.
Interact
Final
with
Cut
that.
Pro has new window.
I'm going to interact with that.
In project timeline, layout.
Head to the beginning, so FN left arrow.
Beginning.
And now you should hear my hand clap. There it is. Head back to the beginning. Then the process is repeated when I go through the audio. So it's the same thing, and I just import that into my timeline as well. And now instead of the letter E, what I'm going to do is I'm going to press the letter Q, which basically is going to drop the clip at the playhead position. This is why I went back to the beginning, just to make sure that the audio syncs up properly.
Connect to primary storyline.
Now Command 2 to go back to my timeline.
Project timeline, layout area. Final Cut Pro has new window.
Interact with that.
In project timeline.
Go back to the beginning. And now if I play it back, it should be synced up or pretty close with the hand claps. Okay, that was pretty well synced up. Now as far as how we basically edit our projects, how does a basic edit look like for you, Tamara?
To do a basic edit, the first thing I need to do is line up my audio and video tracks because they're separate. So I'll move to the beginning of my timeline.
Beginning.
Play. And I'll just hit play to see how close or how far they are.
I'm blind. What do I dream about? I have very
blind.
Play.
So it's very clear that the beginning of this video is off by a lot. Normally, I very deliberately start my video clips before my audio clips, so I just have to bump them right. So what I'll do is I'll interact with my
project timeline layout area. 00:00:00:01 audio clip colon dreaming layout item.
I'll press command down arrow to move to my audio line.
Select below.
And then I will nudge it right and left with the greater than and less than keys, or comma and period. Usually while this is happening, I will shut VoiceOver off just so I can hear the clips a little better.
VoiceOver off.
First off, blindness is a spectrum, and people who are considered legally blind.
Once I've got it close, I can start doing my basic edit. I will usually leave both of my audio tracks live and up just so I can make sure that they are aligned properly and I don't have any drift happening. If I have flubbed sentences, long pauses, coughs, or anything else I want to remove from my video, I'll make a cut. And I do that one of two ways. Command B will cut a single track on the main timeline, but because I want to cut my audio and video together, I press Shift Command B to cut both audio and video tracks. I'll show you that now.
Play.
Shadows or movement.
Here there's a long pause.
When I dream.
Play.
So I want to cut that out. So what I'm going to do is I am going to use my arrow keys left and right to move frame by frame.
Frame.
And I'll move left and right until I hear the end of where I'm talking. Press Shift Command B to cut.
Frame. Blade all. Play.
When
play.
Okay, I just started talking again, so I'm going to move
frame,
backwards.
Frame.
And sometimes I'll turn VoiceOver off here too, because it's really annoying to hear frame while you're moving through.
VoiceOver off.
So I'll scrub left and right until I hear silence, and then I'll press Shift Command B again to cut. Press up arrow to go to the beginning of the cut. Turn VoiceOver back on.
VoiceOver on Final Cut Pro.
Press C to select my clip, and then I press Delete to remove the clip.
Delete.
If we listen to that area again.
Play.
Sometimes shadows are movement. When I dream.
Play.
Now we've removed that long pause. And I'll do that going through my entire video. That's the gist of how I do a basic edit. I'll pass it back to you, Juan.
So this is how my basic edit looks like. When I make my way from one clip to the other in Final Cut, I press Control Option left or right arrow.
0 hours, 0 minutes, and 13 seconds, 29, F clip, test footage, layout item. 0 hours, 0 minutes, and 23 seconds, 14, F clip, test footage, layout item. 0 hours, 0 minutes, and 13.
So in order to make sure I know where I am, I press Control Shift and I.
Range start.
And now if I play it back, it'll play the beginning of the clip.
And Tamara and I have been jokingly called.
And what also helps is that, let's say I want to go back, in this case, the beginning.
Beginning.
Pressing the C key helps me out too.
Select clip.
It selects that clip, but then I press Control Shift I again.
Range start.
And then I play it back.
Hey everybody, what's going on?
So this prevents me from having to press Control Option left or right arrow a bunch of times, because this doesn't help if it's a 10-minute long project. As you previously saw, I hit the FN key. I know it's the globe key, but I'm just used to calling it FN. I hit FN left to go to the beginning.
Beginning.
And to go to the very end of the project, I just hit FN right.
End.
Let me go back to the beginning here.
Beginning.
Now, normally, people hit spacebar to play back footage in Final Cut. The thing is, with VoiceOver, it can get a little annoying. Let me show you. So I'm going to hit spacebar.
Play.
Hey, everybody, what's going on? So I'm really
and I'm
going
to pause again.
Play.
The fact that VoiceOver says play every time I press it, that kind of gets annoying, so this is why I prefer using the JKL keys, because when you press those, if I play L to play it back,
to be sharing this video because,
and K to stop, VoiceOver doesn't say a thing, so I prefer using the JKL keys instead of the spacebar. This is also when I have to go back and forth the frame, if I press left arrow or right arrow.
Frame.
It's also annoying, so in this case I do have to mute VoiceOver if I have to go frame by frame in my timeline. Hey, editing version of me here. Sorry I forgot to add this section, but I wanted to explain really quick how I change levels on my audio with VoiceOver. I'm going to select the audio clip that's below here, so I'm going to press Control Option Down Arrow.
0 hours, 0 minutes, and 13 seconds, 29, audio clip, test audio, layout item.
And it tells me it's an audio clip. So because the volume is already raised, I'm going to lower the levels instead. So to do this, I'm going to press Control and the minus key.
Down, minus 1 dB.
And it tells me that I've lowered the volume down by 1 decibel. Do the opposite by hitting Control plus or equals.
Up, plus 1 dB.
And it increases the volume. So I'm going to go into this in just a little bit more detail about how I handle multiple clips. Because I record audio and video separately, I want to show you how I move a clip around if the audio and video are detached, but I want to move them both to a separate place in the timeline. I have this clip chopped up into 3 pieces. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to move the last portion, the last clip, to the very beginning. So I'm going to head over to the last clip right now.
0 hours, 0 minutes, and 23 seconds, 14. App clip, test footage, layout item.
Okay, so now I'm going to press the letter C.
Select clip.
I'm going to press Control Shift I to make sure I'm at the beginning of the last clip.
Range start.
Play it back.
Hey everybody, what's going on?
Okay, that's not the last clip, so I have to make sure I'm on the right clip.
0 hours, 0 minutes, and 0 seconds, 0, 0. Audio clip, test audio, 0 hours, 0 minutes, and 23 seconds, 14. App clip, test footage, layout item. Range start.
It's February 2022.
Okay, that's the right clip. Sometimes you have to play around with this a little bit. Okay, so now that the right clip is selected, I'm going to press the letter C.
Select clip.
And what I'm going to do now is I'm going to press Control Option Command Return.
0 hours, 0 minutes, and 23 seconds, 14. App clip, test footage, layout item, edit to selection, 1 item selected.
Okay, so that clip is selected, the video clip. Now I'm going to select the audio clip below. I'm going to press Command Down Arrow.
Select below.
Hey, editing version of me again. You actually don't have to press Command Down Arrow. What you have to do is press Control Option Down Arrow or Control Option Up Arrow. Depends whether you're on the video clip or audio clip. And then you follow that up by pressing Control Option Command Return to select the second clip, and then you can continue this with any other clips that you want, and you can select 2, 3, 4, 5 clips, etc. And now I'm going to repeat. I'm going to press Control Option Command Return.
0 hours, 0 minutes, and 23 seconds, 14. App clip, test footage, layout item, edit selection, 2 items selected.
Okay, now both the audio and video are selected, so now what I'm going to do is I'm going to press Command X.
Cut.
To cut, I'm going to jump to the beginning.
Beginning.
Now I'm going to paste this by pressing Command V.
Paste.
And just to make sure, I'm going to go to the beginning again.
Beginning.
And now when I should play it back, it should give me that February 2022 line that I mentioned.
It's February 2022, so.
And there you go. And that's basically how I move a clip around from one portion of the project to another. Now, this happened by accident without me realizing until after I moved the clip. But what happened was a gap clip showed up. So this is a dark clip, just a black clip with nothing on it. And this can be useful at times, but let me show you exactly how that went about, how to basically insert one into your timeline if you want to do that. The way you do this, let me get rid of it actually first.
Delete.
Okay, so the way I would do this is I would go to an edit point. So I'm pressing up and down arrows to go to my edit points. And now let's say I want to put in just an empty black clip. So when you're at the spot that you want to be, you press Option W. And that inserts a black clip. And you can extend this, you can make it shorter, but still, this is good if in case you want to insert a title and you don't want any of your video under the title. Titles, those can be tricky. It really depends on what you're doing. It can be a simple title or it can be something very complicated like credits, rolling credits. So how do you go about doing titles, Tamara?
If I want to insert a title card or something with text on the screen, I can do that a couple of different ways. My preference is usually to avoid going to the generators window and scrolling through. The way I do that is I'll use the shortcut Option T and insert the title.
Basic title.
And then I will
select clip.
Exit my timeline and then go to the inspector.
Change solo time 10. Toggle time vertical splitter. 0, 0, 0, 0, 0 scroll area. 0 basic info inspect color inspect.
I'll select the text inspector.
Select the toggle button. Video, color, inf, basic, 0, 0, colon, scroll area, in scroll area, 119 items, save.
And then I can edit the text to say whatever I want.
You are currently in a text area. Select E, L, L, O,
Hello.
At this point, I will usually have someone who's sighted check and make sure that my text is the correct size and proportion for what I have on screen and that the text isn't running off the sides because I can't tell if that's the case. Sometimes it's a matter of setting it up once for me and then I can copy it in from a template project, and then sometimes I have to get somebody physically come in and help me set that up. But for the most part, I can do that independently. How do you do it, Juan?
For something like titles, I mainly use zoom magnification just because that's one of the more visual things that I have to take care of, so I do get in close and just try to tweak things like that. But lately, I've been starting to do titles with VoiceOver a little bit more, so let me show you how I go about doing that. So the way I would go about with titles, it's basically just like how Tamara mentioned, Control T
basic title
to use the basic title. I don't really go beyond the basic title. I do tweak the font every now and then, maybe the size a little bit, but I don't use really any fancy titles, so basic title usually does the trick for me. Now let me turn VoiceOver off real quick.
VoiceOver off.
And now let me show you what I would use if I'm using zoom magnification. So let me head in close to my timeline.
Project timeline. Item, 0 hours, 0 minutes, and 0 seconds.
Okay, so I'm selecting the title. And now I'm going 24. To go to the inspector.
Project timeline. Toggle audio meet video. Tracking. Vertical alignment. Size slider, 20.2 basic. Basic.
So let's type in something. Okay, so I'm going to just go very basic. This is a title. How exciting of a title.
Title, this is a title. Font.
And then below here, this is alignment. Just the
vertical alignment.
Different settings that I can change if I want to change them.
Tracking.
But I don't go beyond most of these anyway, so this is just mainly how I do titles. Doing effects and transitions, that's definitely one area where it can be challenging if you have low to no vision. So how do you go about doing this, Tamara?
When it comes to adding special effects and transitions, there isn't a whole lot I can do independently. I might add more of that in if I could see more of that, but for the most part, I stick to defaults. If I want to create a basic crossfade, all I have to do is select my file.
Select clip.
And press Command T.
Add cross dissolve.
And it adds the cross dissolve at the beginning and end of the clip automatically. I know we chatted briefly about getting effects onto clips and you said you could do it with drag and drop, but I couldn't get it working. So I'm really curious to see how that works on your end.
For doing effects and transitions, although I don't do that many, this is also another occasion where I do use magnification because it's one of those tasks that's just much simpler to do when you do have some sort of vision like I do. If there's one area where I'm really dependent on the remaining vision that I have, it's for doing effects and transitions. That being said, however, I have been adding and tweaking effects a little bit more with VoiceOver, like I said, just so to save myself from not getting eye strain later on. So for applying effects with VoiceOver, this is what I do. First, I hit Command 5 to activate the effects browser.
Effects, check.
Now, in my timeline, I'm going to make sure that I want the proper clip selected.
0 hours, 0 hours, 0 minutes, and 0 seconds, 0, 0, F clip, test footage, layout height, select clip.
Okay, so press C to select that, get out of my timeline. I'm already there.
Vertical splitter, effects, effects, table, vertical splitter, installed effects, pop grid.
Okay, interact with the grid.
And grid, color board, image.
Now I'm going to look for an effect to apply to the clip.
50 dB, image, 360 degrees noise, 306, add noise, image, H film, image, H paper, image, alien lab, image, artifacts, image, artificial light, image. Artificial light image.
Let's try artificial light. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to press Control Option Comma.
Artificial light. Mark for drag and drop. Artificial light image.
So this gets the effect ready to drag and drop. So now I'm going to exit the effects browser, go back into my timeline.
Installed effects, vertical splitter, effects, table, effects, vertical splitter, project timeline, in project timeline, layout area, 7 items, 0 hours, 0 minutes, and 0 seconds, 0, 0, F clip, test footage, layout item.
Because this clip is already selected, I don't have to do anything. Now I'm going to press Control Option Period.
Dragging artificial light. Artificial light image. Project timeline. Artificial light dropped on 0 hours, 0 minutes, and 0 seconds. 0, 0 clip. Test footage. Item dropped is no longer visible.
And what this did is, this is how drag and drop works with VoiceOver. Now the thing is, drag and drop isn't really the most reliable feature with VoiceOver on the Mac. And from what I could tell, some effects do drag and drop, some don't. And also, what I've noticed is that drag and drop seems to work better or on the M1 Max in comparison to the Intel Max. I could be wrong, but that's just what happened when I was testing things out. So let me apply this effect to another clip. Let me press Command C first to copy it.
Copy.
Now I'm going to go to the clip next door.
0 hours, 0 minutes, and 12 seconds, 15, app clip, test footage, layout item.
And to apply this effect, you press Command Option V.
Paste effect.
That's how you apply it to another clip, and you can keep doing this with the next clip and so on. Let me go to the next clip here.
0 hours, 0 minutes, and 26 seconds, 14, app clip, test footage, layout item.
Let's say you have more than just an effect. You have a bunch of other things that you've tweaked, like the levels or just cropped into the video or something like that. Let's say you want to paste those attributes. So in this case, let's just go to the previous clip.
0 hours, 0 minutes, and 12 seconds.
And let's press Command C to copy again.
Copy. 0 hours, 0 minutes, and
go to the next clip. And now to paste the attributes, if you want to do that, you press Shift Command V.
Video attributes, mix, checkbox, paste attributes, copy from, test footage.
And this gives you a list of what you want copied or not. Let's say you want just one thing copied instead of everything. So you can checkbox anything that you want and leave out anything that you don't want. But in this case, I don't want anything, so I'm just going to hit cancel.
Paste, default button, cancel button, paste attributes.
That's basically how I, it's basically how I take care of effects in Final Cut. White balance, adjusting white balance. If you have some sort of vision, it might be more manageable to be able to adjust those settings, but when you have no vision, it's going to be very problematic. So Tamara, let me know how you go about with white balance.
In order to white balance, I have to rely on the auto features. I can't go in and see subtle variations in color or match one clip to the next or make sure everything looks good. I will usually have someone sighted double check after I've auto white balanced, but to auto white balance, I use Command Option B.
Balance color checked.
How do you handle white balancing and color balancing, Juan?
In my case, the way I do this, I actually try to white balance just in camera as much as possible. I really try to avoid doing this in post. But if I have to, then I do tweak things here and there. But I mean, if I do that, it's with low vision settings. When I do have to do color correction, though, that's when I use low vision settings. And that's definitely one area where I really, you know, would have to use my eyes as much as possible. But like I said, this is why I try to avoid color correcting in post, because I just like to do the white balancing in camera as much as possible. So one little bonus thing that I want to mention is I also caption my videos. So if you're wondering how to add captions and you're wanting to do this with VoiceOver, there's actually a way of going about doing this. And let me show you how. I'm going to go to the beginning of my project.
Beginning.
It's February 2022.
Okay, it's February 2022, so I'm going to go back to the beginning. Now I'm going to press Option C.
Go to the previous caption button.
And this opens up the caption window. So now this gives me a few options here. If I go back and forth really quick.
Go to the previous caption button.
If I have a caption before that, I can go to the previous one.
Formatted vertical line language English menu button. Change the caption role or role assignment.
I can change the language.
Go to the next caption button.
Go to the next caption.
Edit text.
And now I can just start typing. So I said it's February 2022. And if you want to go back and forth between words, you hold down Option left and right arrow.
2022.
Not at the same time, Option left or Option right.
February. It's February 2022.
If you want to go one character at a time, just left and right arrows by themselves.
2202YRA alpha.
And to exit the caption window, just press Escape.
0 hours, 0 minutes, and 0 seconds, 00, caption, it's February, 2022, layout item.
So let's say I want to extend this caption. Let's say it's not long enough, so I want to extend it by, let's say, a couple seconds. What I'm going to do is I'm going to press the letter C.
Select clip.
Control-Shift-I.
Range start.
To be at the beginning.
It's February.
Now I'm going to press down arrow, because that takes me where the caption ends. Press the left bracket key. And now I'm going to play back the video a little bit.
So, yeah, you can kind of see why we jokingly.
Okay, so I stopped it here. And to extend the edit, I'm going to hold down Shift and X.
Extend edit.
And now it extended the caption. Now the tricky part here is sometimes when you're editing a caption, if you want to extend it, like I said, press down arrow. But the thing is, it's going to run into the first edit that it picks up. And that might be a video clip. So you might accidentally be extending a video clip below. So just be very careful when doing captions, because sometimes you might end up extending a video clip by mistake, thinking that it's the caption. And if you happen to extend the video clip by mistake, all you have to do is just hit the undo button, so Command Z. And instead of pressing the down arrow after you selected the clip once, press it a second time, and that should basically take you to the end of the caption right there. So yeah, that's basically a little summary of how we edit videos as blind people using Final Cut Pro. Now, we didn't include every single step because that would have been a much longer video, but still, you get the picture, and hopefully this kind of gives you a bit more of insight on how Final Cut Pro works with accessibility features like VoiceOver and Zoom magnification. I want to say thank you to Tamara because you've been awesome in just hanging around and, you know, doing this project. And yeah, it didn't go well just the first time around, but you know what? We got it done. So thank you for just sticking around and finishing this collab with me.
Thank you so much for including me in this collab. It was such a joy from start to finish, even though it took us a little longer than expected. I learned so much, especially behind the scenes, and you showed me so many cool little shortcuts that I would have never considered. I hope we get to work again together soon.
Like I said, go check out Tamara's channel. I'm gonna leave a link in the description and on the card in the corner. And if you want to check out the second half of our collab talking about how we shoot videos as blind people, then go check that out. I'm also leaving a link in the description for that as well. Anyway, thank you guys for hanging around this long to check out this rather lengthy video. But yeah, so I hope to see you guys next time. And yeah, I'll talk to you later. Bye.